Hello everyone, this is Gamer, and welcome back to Max Payne 3, where Max is... bald? Okay.
Get down behind the desk, now, both of you.
Here we go. We're already starting into the madness.
Max!
Yeah, it's safe. Come on.
We need to get you to the server room. Let's go.
Por que não posso ficar aqui com você debaixo da mesa?
Let's go. Come on.
Okay. I'm coming. Come on.
The real security guards had been run off, paid off, or bumped off. That left us. It wasn't a fantastically comforting thought.
Let's do this together!
This code should get us into the boardroom. Okay.
Glad to see the security system is keeping the right people out.
Ah! Oh, shit!
Jump one more time. Got him.
Are we dead?
No such luck. We gotta go.
It's through here.
The server room is just past those cubicles.
These clowns were the same guns for hire who jumped our exchange at the stadium. Crotch a Prado, the black badge. Right-wing paramilitary chumps protecting whoever paid the most. I guess that made them more like me than I cared to admit. Were they just looking for another payday, or did their business with the Broncos run deeper?
Eu vou por aqui, você vai por ali. Demorou.
Preciso de proteção, pô!
Atire! Não pare! Atire!
Puta que pariu!
Got him. Got him.
Hey. Good to go. Let's get that server back online.
Can we just spend a few more minutes? Make sure they're all gone?
Really?
Come on, don't worry. I got your back.
Poor kid was scared shitless. But I thought we'd seen the worst of it.
Okay. The server room is just down here.
You're doing good. Come on.
Hey, I didn't think I'd have a day like this when I wake up in the mornings.
Wish I could say the same thing.
Fact was, I'd gotten used to protecting Branco in the big bad world. We hadn't anticipated a siege situation here, hadn't prepared for it. I couldn't tell the kid that. Something told me these guys didn't have security clearance.
Oh god. What?
This doesn't look good.
No, it doesn't. And I died. Crap.
Mata o filho da puta!
Oh my god. That really screwed me over. Oh boy, I need to think more strategically because I don't have no painkillers at all. So far, so good.
Come on, move. You gonna be able to fix this or what?
In a few minutes, eh? I should be able to reboot the system, get all the components back online.
What about Bronco's office? That's all I care about.
He should be able to lock us down, eh? If this works.
All right, whatever you're doing, do it quick. I'm gonna make a sweep of the building and then get back to Rodrigo's.
I shouldn't have said that to the kid. I felt bad.
Security system was back online. Things might be a little tougher for our fan club from here on in. Seemed like breaching the perimeter had been no more difficult than strolling through the front gates. But hey, who needs a Trojan horse when the alarm is down and your standing army is a dame, a dork, and a drunk? Bronco's office overlooked the atrium. I could check in and make sure he hadn't checked out.
Okay. I shouldn't have said that to the kid, though. I felt bad, though. Because if I was in his feet, I probably would be scared. I probably would be scared shitless, too. Okay.
Max!
Your guy's working on the security system now, sir.
It just came on.
Okay, good. Then lock yourself down. Stay put. Let us take care of these guys down here. Once they realize they can't get to you, they should back off.
Max! Try not to completely destroy the place.
Let's just concentrate on staying alive. Sir!
There it went. He was tucked up safe. Now I needed to make it to the lobby to complete my sweep of the building, for what that was worth.
I could really use some painkillers, though. Oh, bathroom.
They could replace these on Monday morning.
Nice line. Well, at least I got one painkiller. That's not too bad. Oh.
Graduation shots of Rodrigo, Victor, and Marcelo, educated at rich kid finishing schools all over Europe. No wonder they had the common touch.
Oh no.
Poor girl was dead. Shot through the head by some hero fighting the rich one lonely secretary at a time.
Hey, What are you gonna do, Max? Pop the tire. Oh. Wow, I could have done nothing. Wait, could I shoot the driver? Max. Oh my dear lord. Max, how can I not like you after that? After seeing that, that was awesome. Ooh, got him. Aw, hell. What am I supposed to do now? Oh no! Are you serious? I'm dead. Ooh! How do I switch, cameras. I keep on forgetting how to switch cameras, man. Dang it, man. Oh, it's H. Aw, man, this is tough. Oh, thank God.
It looked like we had seen the worst of it. The elevator would take me back up to Rodrigo's office where we could wait the rest of it out.
Nah. I'd rather take this gun. My God, I'm in so much pain. Like, no pun intended. I'm in so much pain. All right, how do we, yeah.
I didn't know what the hell I was gonna find up there, but I sensed it wasn't gonna be a stripper bursting out of a cake.
Senor Branco! Senor Branco! I can't get through to him. Ever since the security door is triggered, he hasn't made a sound.
Rodrigo, it's Max. Open up. Can you hear me?
Yo ya intenté.
Señor Branco, open up. I'm gonna try to get in there from the roof. You find the security guard and get the hell out of here.
Yes.
I knew there was another way in upstairs for the helipad, the little luxury runaround that kept the rich looking down on the poor literally as well as metaphorically.
Rodrigo! Shit.
God damn it.
Of course, he was dead. Clean, one shot, a professional job. I began to look for clues. I couldn't get playback on one of the cameras, and it looked like the disc was missing. Someone in this building was trying to keep things low-key. But then why had everyone else come driving through the goddamn wall? Fabiana. Even if the man who employed me was dead, his wife was still out there. Maybe she could be saved. Maybe some good... Picking the photo from the broken fragments, something caught my eye.
Figures.
Uh-oh. Oh!
Only blind luck it meant the blast wasn't fatal. If I'd been out for any longer, the smoke would have gotten me.
Did I lose all my weapons?
Perfect. If I wasn't immolated, I was gonna get crushed to death. Look at me. I've been contracted to protect two people. One was being held in some hole. The other was sitting at his desk with a bullet in his head. And the company that had its logo on my paycheck was melting on top of my head. Shit. If I survived this, it'd be a victory for gross incompetence. The kid hadn't made it. Fuck. I had to make this corpse-looting coward pay. Getting his gun was more than just expediency.
Oh! Dang, he didn't make it.
No one would be rebooting his system. Poor bastard.
What? What the heck? Man. Oh, good. He doesn't repeat it. Good. Are you flipping kidding me? Oh, this is gonna be tough. Especially with no dang painkillers.
If the heat didn't kill me, the fumes would.
But then those idiots will... But the bullets will kill me. Wow. Oh!
Rodrigo or not, Fabricas Branco is falling apart quite literally. Despite his manners, I'd done him a favor.
I sure as hell did. He should be thanking me.
This didn't look like a room where Rodrigo closed multi-million dollar deals. It looked like a fiery hellhole.
Got him.
The only way out was to use that filing cabinet.
Oh! Jesus. We gotta get out of here.
So much for a lazy Sunday afternoon. My next trick would be a high wire act with a fiery pit for a safety net. It was nice that no one was shooting at me for a change, but I'd take shot in the head over a slow roast on a spit any day of the goddamn week.
Yeah, I'd rather get shot than burned alive. Ooh. Oh, that's gonna sting in the morning.
Someone up ahead was hurt pretty bad. If he didn't die before I got to him, I might get some answers.
All right, let's interrogate him.
Hey, why? Why Rodrigo Branco?
Why? What?
Why did you come to kill Rodrigo Branco?
Came to kill you. Because what you did to us. You killed so many of us.
What reason did this poor bastard have to lie? He would be dead from shock or loss of blood in half an hour. Even if I didn't leave him there to burn.
Where's Fabiana?
What?
Fabiana Branco, where is she?
La Comando Sombra got her. Up to you.
Then it was up the hill for me, I guess, where the gang held sway. I had to try to figure out who was using these angry paramilitary clowns as some kind of front to kill Rodrigo. I was a mess. Rodrigo Branco was dead. Fabiana was held hostage. I had no idea who was behind any of this. I felt like a fool. I was a sweaty, gray-haired mess. This place, well, this place was gonna kill me, too. I could see that now. I decided that I was gonna die sober, not drunk. At least then I would see who shot me. It was time to take back control from whoever was out to get me. And if I didn't flush them out, at least my midlife crisis would confuse them enough so they did something stupid. It was the only hope I had. I knew I wasn't thinking straight. I'd been drinking and popping painkillers for years. I had a liver like a French goose and skin like red leather.
Hair shaving.
Well, it wasn't perfect. In fact, it wasn't much good at all, but it was gonna have to do. At least I was facing in the right direction.
Hello.
Hello, Victor.
Max? Max, you're alive?
Of course I'm alive.
We did not know this. We are lost, Max. Our brother was everything to us.
I understand. Listen, I'm sorry about your loss. Both of you. Rodrigo was a good man. I failed him. But I was tricked.
What happened, Max?
I don't know.
Some guys from the Crush of Prado came into the building downstairs, so while me and the security guard were dealing with them,
An assassin must have come in and executed your brother. At least that's how I think it happened.
No, you killed him, Poha. You killed my brother.
What are you talking about? I understand you're upset, but please, why the hell would I do that?
To get his money, to take his money.
How am I getting his money, Marcelo? Please, think. I worked my ass off for your family. I saved your life twice or more. Right now, I'm going to get Fabiana.
Where is she? Where is Fabiana, eh?
She's in a place called Nova Esperanza.
How do you know this, Max?
One of the Crotcher Prado told me just before he died.
Please, bring our sister-in-law back to us, Max. Our family is being torn apart.
A hangover sent direct from Mother Advice? Mother Nature? What is it? I don't know.
So I guess I was finally about to go and experience the other side of Sao Paulo firsthand. The bit people try to ignore. The unpleasant memory they try to obliterate with cocktails and helicopters and parties and lines of blow, like rich fools the world over. I was a day off the sauce for the first time in years and knew I was due a hangover sent direct from Mother Nature.
Don't make fun of soccer.
I had no idea where the hell I was gonna go, so I decided to head straight for the street party that seemed to be raging. Either that or some other fool had gotten there before me and now was being ritually sacrificed. I've had better ideas, but then I've also had worse ones, like accepting this job in the first place.
E aí, gringo?
Get lost, kid.
Eu me amarro nos States. Você precisa de ajuda, senhor?
Speak English?
Aham, falo sim, sem problema.
Need to know if you ever seen this girl, Fabiana. Come here for a second, look at her.
I know lots of girls, sexy. Come on, come on. This way.
Where are you going? Wait a minute. Down there?
É isso.
Jesus. At least I had found myself a tour guide.
Alright guys, I'm going to have to end my video here. If you like this series of videos, please give this video a like. Comment on this video on how you like the game so far. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see more gaming videos like these. Alright, this has been Gamer. Peace out, and I'll definitely see you on the next episode of Max Payne 3, which this little kid will be my tour guide of the favela side of Brazil. I forgot the name of this town already. It's Sao Paulo? Sao Paulo? That's how you say it? I'm pretty sure I messed that name up. Oh, God. Anywho, bye, everyone. Jeez, I butchered names so badly today.